And now we continue with the excitement at TIFF by just bumping into the famous critic from the Christian Science Monitor. It's Peter Rayner. Hey, Peter.
Hi, Steve.
You had some meeting life because I missed you in Montreal. Like, you left and I arrived. And
two ships that passed in the night.
Yeah, and everybody in Montreal left the first 6 days. So there was, I was there the
so
last
you
six.
Had a lot of people to interview.
No, I was interviewing people like the wonderful Tamara Sherbeck, a student.
Yeah.
She was wonderful, but she's a student. Anyway, we're now at the Toronto Film Festival, and what have you seen that you've liked, sir?
Well, I've seen about 16 movies, I think, altogether.
I think, you mean yesterday.
Yeah, right.
It's a busy,
they all blend together. The
yes.
From Kazakhstan
right.
And the George Clooney movie all kind of. It's hard to keep them apart, and I'm not one of these people with a lighted pen so that you can take
right.
Can't
hate
I
those things. Anymore. And now they have those things, the blackberries, that just
yeah,
like, light up the whole room every time somebody turns on.
Exactly. I have seen quite a few recommendable movies.
Okay.
As, Up in the Air, which is.
I didn't see that now that that's with Clooney.
Yeah.
And Reitman directed it. Is it Jason
yes,
or Ivan? Jason.
Jason.
The son.
Did it. Vera Farmiga is in it. They have terrific chemistry together. It's a sweet little movie. It's about a guy who goes around the country firing people. That's what he does for a living.
Okay.
And so there's a lot of connections to the audience in this story. It's based on a Walter Kern novel. So that was good. There was a very serious man, the Coen Brothers movie.
I saw that too.
People are very divided on it. I liked it. I think it's
well. I think it divides you into Jewish or non, Jewish yeah. And goy. You know, I think
could be. Well,
I'm a goy, but I liked it. You
yeah,
know,
well,
but I no Jews just loved it. So
yeah. Well, I didn't get high on my bar mitzvah, put it that way.
Oh.
So I didn't relate to that scene. But I think it. You know, it's kind of like watching somebody pick wings off. Fly at times, which is typical of the Coen brothers too. But
it seemed like it was based on the Book of Job. You know,
yeah.
A serious man starring the wonderful New York stage actor Michael Stuhlbarg. I don't know.
Yeah, he's wonderful. It's nice to see a movie where you don't automatically register who all the actors are. You know.
Yes, they're completely unknown except for Richard Kine.
Right, right. And even he is not, you know, sort of a big A-list actor. It just shows you how many wonderful actors are out there who aren't really, you know, utilized enough in the movies. So I like those two. I liked a wonderful documentary called The Genius Within about Glenn Gould. Glenn Gould, who's a Toronto native.
Yes,
Toronto
pianist, native. Great pianist.
Great pianist, died at 50. It's for somebody who was so eccentric and reclusive, it's amazing the amount of footage they had on his life. I mean, he was someone who used to walk around in the heat of the summer wearing a heavy winter coat. He had gloves that he just cut out the tips of the fingers and he could play concerts with his gloves on with the seat very low to the keyboard. You know, he hummed and sang when he played. He took a million pills. And, he was a terrible hypochondriac. You know.
Sounds like a typical New Yorker.
Yeah,
in Canada, they're like, what's going on here?
But he hated New York. He had many opportunities to live there. And he finally stopped concertizing altogether. And he did a lot of very innovative work in radio and television in Canada, as well as recording. But, you know.
And this is a documentary?
It's a documentary. The co-director is Peter Raymond, who's a wonderful documentary filmmaker from here, I believe. And, they got footage of Glenn Gould cavorting in the Bahamas surf with native girls, you know, I mean, kind of not exactly what you expect. The Michael Moore documentary,
which I also haven't seen yet.
Yeah.
Oh God, I haven't seen any of these.
Yeah, well, it's funny because capitalism, a love story, and then there was the capitalism after party. You know, I mean, it's a lot of money went into that. Also, a lot of corporate sponsors on screen before the film comes on.
What's the
so
film about?
A lot of irony.
Is it a doc? He always makes
oh, yeah, it's a documentary. It's a history of capitalism.
Oh, okay.
From his perspective, Paul's in, you know, Flint, Michigan, and GM, and the current recession and all that stuff, and it makes
which isn't happening here in Ontario, at least,
really?
By the way. No, Canada's like totally solvent.
Yeah, he was kind of warning that it could happen here. There were some striking hard hat workers who were in the audience wearing their hats, and you know, he was in sympathy with them. And I think they were from Edmonton. Anyway, it's, you know, it's a once over lightly gloss of the history of capitalism, to put it mildly. And I think his politics tend to be very opportunistic, depending on, you know, what he's talking about. But it is pretty fascinating, some of the clips that he got. There's a clip of FDR giving a speech not long before he died, where he talks about all of these things that he wanted for the country, including universal health care. And this footage was lost forever, supposedly, and they found it in a box in South Dakota somewhere. Even the Roosevelt family had no record of it. And it's quite moving to see him talk about this. So, you know, there was that, and then there's a film from Kazakhstan, not Borat.
the anti-Borat film.
Called
yeah.
Killin, K-E-L-I-N.
Oh, yes. I thought it was Irish. What is it? I looked at another Irish.
That's O'Kellen.
O'Kellen, yeah. Right.
No, Killin was, it's set, you know, like who knows, 1,000 years ago. Everybody's bundled up, you know, in the tundra. And heavily parked, but a lot, they really get it on. I mean, there's a lot of you know, screwing in huts and, you know, in the middle of snowstorms, and it wasn't quite what I expected. The people are all, you know, beautiful. They all have great teeth, which I always sort of wonder how that happens when, you know, what you're doing is, you know, gnawing on caribou bones, and there isn't a dental clinic in sight in the Kazakh tundra, but it was an interesting film. The film I really hated was Harry Brown with Michael Caine.
Oh God, I loved that. But anyway,
you did?
Yes, I had Emily Mortimer on a career interview for both her and myself for 17 minutes. But anyway, you liked it.
Yeah, well, no, I mean, I thought it was sort of
you
like,
hated it.
Yeah, I don't want to be quoted.
Right.
It was, you know, it's like Death Wish, and let's see if we can make a Death Wish. In fact, I think it's the worst film Michael Caine has ever made with a budget of under $20 million. Because I know he's made, like, Swarm and Jaws, too. There's a couple of... anyway, but he's a great actor. Not in that movie. What else did I like?
Did you see Broken Embraces?
I didn't. That screened the day I arrived. So I was able to get
wonderful.
Yeah, I'll
it's
see that.
It's not
in New
as
York.
Good as Volver, but it's pretty damn good.
Yeah, yeah. I'll see that. I'll see
did
that.
Did you see An Education?
I did. I mostly like that. I think the Sarsgaard and
Carey Mulligan.
I think it goes a bit off in the last 20 minutes or so in terms of how it wraps up the story and all, but I think it's like it's pretty good. The Damned United, another Peter Morgan scripted docudrama. I don't know anything about soccer really, but I found it pretty engrossing, and Michael Sheen, wonderful in it as a soccer coach.
Did you see The White Ribbon?
I did.
I love
it. We don't agree on
anything. We don't agree on anything this year. Das Weiße Bande in German, it's the it's by Peter Haneke. I just was blown away by
Michael Haneke. Yeah.
Michael Haneke, thank you. Peter Rayner, who I'm talking to here on the Stephen Hull Show. I can remember my own name, but that's about it. So, Peter, you didn't like it? Or?
Well, I think it's very... It's sort of beautifully made, but somehow it seemed to me like it was kind of a... It's like an M. Night Shyamalan movie with a PhD. And I would say of Antichrist, that's a Herschel Gordon Lewis horror movie with a PhD. Have you seen Antichrist?
Yes, yes.
You love
yes.
it.
No, I hated it.
All right, good.
That. I thought it was disgusting. That's the big talk of the festival, the self-mutilation scene by the leading actress. I can't go further into that moment.
That was a bit much.
Thank you for filling us in.
That's the way to do it, and you know, but I'm still around if you want to do a final recap.
All right, okay.
Well,
exactly.
Always.
I've seen them all over, and I changed my mind on everything.
Oh, all right. Okay, so thank you so much.
Thank
Peter
you.
Reiner of the Christian Science Monitor here today at the Toronto Film Festival on the Stephen Holt Show. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Stephen. Write down, you know,
my... All right, my...